Welcome back. You are still watching The Link right here on SABC1. I'm Zansi for sure. Every Wednesday at 6:30. Don't forget to interact with us by hashtagging us on Twitter. That's hashtag The Link. And sitting in studio with me right now is the oh so gorgeous Refile Mudisile. She's an actress, she's a singer, and she's a model. What are you not? Besides a wife and a mother.
Not a prima donna.
Oh, thank you. Where are you from?
Originally born and bred in Soweto, was born in Rockville, but when I was 4 years old, my parents decided to move to Orange Grove.
It's quite vibey, that side of town, I must say. Lots of arts and things happening.
I mean, it's a Jewish community.
What are you trying to tell us, Refile?
I fit it in with the white people just nicely.
Listen to you. What did you study after school, after high school?
I went to Varsity College to study advertising, where I acquired my 5 distinction graduate in advertising.
When did you decide, you know what, I want to get into modeling and I want to sing and...
Wow. You know what, my story is a bit crazy because I started modeling when I was 13 and my mom felt that she had to protect me. Mm-hmm. So she kind of drew me away from that entire thing and was like, no, if you want to do something like this, do it after matric. So that's the modeling part of things.
Okay.
You know when they say sometimes in life you have callings?
Yeah.
It became a calling because mm-hmm. when I was not looking, I'd have people scouting and saying, you know, we'd love to use you for a shoot.
Yes.
Started modeling for David, my cherry, and the singing came the year after that.
And you used to back for KB and all those people.
I did. Wow. I was a backing vocalist for KB. So I was doing
that. I didn't even know that.
How come I'm not feeling you?
Oh,
so I was
doing
that whole, I was in that video.
I remember. But now, Refile, you know, I think about 2 weeks ago, you and I were having a conversation about the modeling industry, going back to modeling.
Yeah.
And you spoke about how it's so hard for you to get bookings, you know,
it's
whereby
true.
You get recognized internationally instead of your own home ground.
Yeah.
What is that all about?
I think the saddest reality for me was where they cast and they say, we're looking for a black girl.
Yes.
But I do not define, according to them,
mm-hmm.
what is a black girl.
Mm.
So it's going to be a constant battle, but it's one that I'm willing to fight because I've gotten this far.
But how do you think you can change that mindset? Because, I mean, internationally, you know, it's not an issue anymore. Yeah, you get respect.
I get respect. Yeah. I get more respect. The funny thing is, the beginning of this year, I think it was about January, February, that's when I broke news internationally, where there was news in the UK about me. There was news in Jamaica, mm-hmm. I have a following in Italy, I have a following in Netherlands and France. You know, it's countries like that. But the funny thing is, I was like, it took outside acknowledgement first.
It's always like
before
that.
A certain publication went and put that out.
Mm.
I was like, really?
Yeah.
Wow. And it's a sad reality. You're like, okay, you know what? This is going to make me fight just as hard for everything I want because I'm going to pursue my passions. It's not about proving a point.
Yes.
It's about saying that you have the capability and the potential to do the things that you're God-given with.
What else are you working on right now?
Wow, movie coming up. A lot of people didn't know that I now have gone into acting. I did my first short film last year.
Mm-hmm.
I am going into a film with the ever so infamous Akin Omotoso.
Wow, that's huge.
So, but I don't want to give too much away, but it's his first romantic comedy, so.
Okay.
I'm going in as a, possibly
sweet
myself.
As a sweet something,
as
Yana.
As a sweet something.
And a sexy something. But babe, you know, I mean, you've been in the industry for such a long time, and we've actually seen your fashion. Your fashion is on point. Who dresses you?
I dress myself.
Yeah.
I've always dressed myself. I've never been a labels girl.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not a girl who will go out and say I'm wearing a Gucci or Versace or Louis Vuitton.
And I mean, you don't have to wear expensive items to
be a
fashion icon.
You don't. Let me tell you, it's all about wearing what is comfortable for you and your body and what looks good.
Okay, are you on Twitter or Facebook?
I am. Yes. I am on Twitter as @VanillaBlack and Facebook. It's Refile Fifi Mudisile.
Well, I wish you all the best. You have definitely broken so many boundaries for a lot of young girls that look up to you.
Thank you, Mama.
But next up, the news.